Hello students, how are you all? I hope you all are doing good. Children, as you all are aware that we had started our chapter 11, that is light, shadows and reflection. So we were doing in our last class, we were doing about light. So what do you mean by light? Light means a source, which light is a form of energy. And light only enables the things which are present in our surrounding to see. If light fall on any object, then only that thing is visible to us. We are able to see anything. If light is falling on that object and then entering to our eyes, so then only that object is visible to us. Now, it means there are different sources of light also will be there. Yes, there are different sources of light. Like an object, what do you mean by sources of light first? An object which emit light or which gives out light is called source of light. Like we have bulb, we have tube light, we have sun, moon, stars, all these are oil lamp is also an example of source of light. Now there are certain natural sources of light and certain man-made sources of light will be there. Natural sources means the source of light which occur naturally. The source of light which occur naturally means that is occur in the nature. That was not kept by anybody in the nature. That was all. Already it is occurring in the nature. So that is natural source of light. Man-made, which is created by man, which is formed by man, that is man-made source of light. Now natural source of light is like sun, moon, stars, fireflies, they comes in natural source of light. Man-made sources of light means tube light, torch, oil lamp, then these all are bulb, all these are natural source of light. After that we have done, that is luminous and non-luminous object. Now luminous means what? Luminous and non-luminous object. Now luminous means the object which emit light, that will comes in luminous object. The object which emits light or gives out its own light is called luminous object. Means many objects were there like bulb, tube light, all these are also emitting light, but they are not emitting their own light. Fine. So there are certain objects which gives out its own light, like sun. Sun is an example of a luminous object. Tube light, bulb, these are emitting their own light. But if here I am going to take example of moon. Moon is not a is comes in like a luminous object. So it is giving its light, or the light which it is stored by stars, they are also comes in luminous object. Now non-luminous object are the object which does not give its own light. Fine. Non-luminous object means an object which does not give out its own light is called non-luminous object. Like table, chair, book, shelf, flower pot, any plant is also comes in non-luminous object. Now here if I am going to take an example of that, many of times it is asked that what is the difference between luminous and non-luminous object, and that only you have to explain. Now a flower is a non-luminous object. Obviously when you are going to stand in front of a flower, that flower is not giving light. We can see many things kept in a room during the day. Why is it so? Since in the daytime we have sun which is giving light, and we can observe many things or we can see many things. Since the light which comes from sun, it is reflected by that particular object and enters into our eyes, and that only make the things visible. But at night we require other luminous object, like we require tube light, we require bulb. Now at night what happens, the light which comes from tube light strike with that object and then enters in our eyes, then only that object is visible to us. Now we have next, that is transparent, translucent and opaque material. Luminous, after that we have transparent, translucent and opaque. Transparent, translucent and opaque material. Opaque material. So let us understand what is this, what is transparent, translucent and opaque material. So transparent, first of all, transparent material is a material like those material which allow the light to pass through them completely. Fine, transparent material or transparent object. Now here number one will be transparent, it can be called transparent material or transparent object. Transparent objects. So what does they do, transparent material and transparent object, what does they do? That is, transparent material or transparent object. Now these object allows the light to pass through them completely. Fine, those material which allows all the light to pass through them are called transparent material. So now if you require to write it down, that what is transparent material or transparent object. Many of times you will be finding while writing it like transparent object. Somewhere you will be finding that transparent object. Somewhere you are going to find it out transparent material. So both are correct only. You can mention it with any name. Fine. Now what do you mean by this transparent? The object. Transparent material. So I am going to erase these two. And we'll be discussing this transparent material. So transparent material, those materials which allow all the light to pass through them are called transparent material. So what do we understand here? The material which allows all the light to pass through them are called transparent material. Now for example, glass, glass, polythene, water, air, groundnut oil, water, then air and groundnut oil are transparent material. So what do we understand here? That the material which allows or which allow all the light to pass through them are called transparent material. Now transparent material, they allow all the light to pass through them. Completely they allow all the light to pass through them. Completely they allow the light to pass through them. Completely. Like glass, polythene, water, they are not going to obstruct any light. Fine. So if you will see, or if you will see through your window pane, you will be able to see clearly that what atmosphere is there outside, what kind of a weather you have outside, who is coming from outside, and whatever is happening outside, that is clearly visible when you look through your glass pane, which is normally used in windows. Fine. So polythene like plastic bags, if you are carrying anything in that plastic bag, that is visible. Why is it visible? Since that plastic bag is allowing the light to pass through. Again, in a glass tumbler, if you are going to take water, that also you can see the quantity of water. Why is it so? Since that water is also allowing the light to pass through them. So again, that is also visible to you. Air is transparent only, since everywhere you have air, but you can see all those things clearly. So that is air. And groundnut oil means that is a moongfli tail, peanut oil. So that also, that is visible due to that. Okay. Now after that, if we are able to see through an object clearly, it means it is allowing all the light to pass through them, and hence it is a transparent material. So how we will be able to find it out? I am going to, like, if I'll take any object and if I'll take a book, I'll just see, find it out that can I see through that book? If could not, then that book is not a transparent material. That book is not a transparent material. So now we'll come to next, transparent material. I hope that is clear. Now we'll come to next, number 2. We were doing transparent, then we have translucent material. Next is number 2, that is translucent material. So what do you mean by this translucent material? Translucent material means that a material, or those material which does not allow the light to pass through them completely, or some of the light can only pass through them. So how we can write this definition? Those material which allow only some of the light to pass through them are called translucent material. So it is going to pass only some light through them. Now translucent material, now here, for example, so what do we understand by the definition? That those material which allow only some of the light to pass through them. Those material which allow only some of the light means that light which fallen on that object, they are not going to pass completely. Only some of the light is going to pass through them. So that is your translucent material. That is your translucent material. For example, in other word, light passes only partially. Many of time the definition you will be finding it that somewhere in the book it is written that the material which allow only partially or which allow the light to pass through them partially are called translucent material. Now in other words we can mention light passes only partially. Light passes only partially through translucent material. Now the material like ground glass or frosted glass, ground glass which is used to make that bottles. Now butter paper or tracing paper, oiled paper is also a translucent material. Sheet of a white cotton, muddy water, clouds, these are the example of translucent material. Like what we can write, for example, ground glass, then we have butter paper or tracing paper. Butter paper, sometimes it is called tracing paper. Butter paper, then oily or greased paper. Fine, oily paper, oiled paper, tissue paper, cotton paper, etc. and muddy water. These are the certain examples of translucent material. So translucent material are those they allow only part of light falling on the surface to pass through them. We cannot see clearly through this translucent material since they only allow some light to pass through them. Look at the burning candle through a piece of a ground glass. You will be finding it that only some of the light can pass through it and you can see only the sunlight. Now opaque material we are going to do, that is your third one. Opaque material is the third one, which we are going to discuss today in today's class. The material which do not allow any light to pass through them. Any light to pass through them are called opaque material. For example, now here opaque examples you can take it many, like your door, wooden door, windows which are made from wood. So things like metal door, windows which are made up of wood, then we have metal sheet, brick wall, then what do we have next? That is cardboard, book. All these are the example. You can write many more examples. All these are the example of, yes, that is an example of opaque material. So opaque material allows does not allow the light to pass through them. Opaque material, those materials which do not allow any light to pass through them. They do not allow any light to pass through them are called opaque material. Now for example, door, windows, wood and all these things. Now since they does not allow any light to pass through them, that is why only we cannot see through them. We cannot see through them since it is not allowing object to pass any light through them. Now hence it is a opaque object. Opaque object do not allow opaque. Sometimes it is called opaque material also. Sometimes it is called opaque object also. So both are correct. Now a major difference between transparent, translucent and opaque material we have done, and that will only help you to categorize between that whether the given object or any source of light or anything which comes among transparent, translucent or opaque. Now opaque material also we have done, so you can identify difference between these two. Now we are going to do the next topic in the next class. Today I will be finishing the topic here. So that's all for today. Have a good day.